Well, hey friends, it's Dawn. Welcome back to another video. This one is going to be so much fun. All right, if you are new here, my name is Dawn. I am an independent beauty consultant with Mary Kay Cosmetics. I've been doing that for a long time, and I started my channel about a year ago to help my customers with makeup tutorials, product reviews, and new product releases. And along the way, a lot of other people have joined me. So if you are new, welcome to the community. And if you are a returning subscriber, I appreciate you so much. Thanks for coming back week after week. Thanks for commenting. Thanks for saying hello on my social media channel, signing up for my newsletter, all of that fun stuff. So I just love our community, and this channel is dedicated to you. My makeup tutorials are really for the everyday woman who is looking for just everyday makeup that she can wear to the office, for date night with her husband, or maybe, you know, brunch with their girlfriends. And I know we live in a COVID world right now where there's not a lot of activities going on depending on where you live in the country, but one day we're going to get back there. So I know this has been a great time for a lot of people to be practicing their techniques, and I hope that these videos are helpful to you. So as you watch my videos, if you find them helpful, give me a thumbs up because that helps me know what kind of content to create for you. And if you are not yet subscribed, make sure you hit that red subscribe button, and then that way you'll know every time I upload a new video. All right, if you love this video and you enjoy it as much as I do, make sure that you share it with a friend. And today's video has been highly requested. I did a poll a while ago asking my customers what they'd like to see, and overwhelmingly, it was unanimous. This was the video: makeup mistakes. Are you making any of these? All right, so if you have been watching my videos, I hope you know that I have a great sense of humor. I love to laugh at myself, and this video is in no way meant to be mean or to belittle or to put anyone down. So if you are doing any of the mistakes, you know what? It's makeup, it's fun, who cares, right? But I have noticed with the trends of my videos, the majority of my viewers are age 35 plus. So there are certain things as we start to age that we need to tweak a little bit, because if we don't, those makeup mistakes can age us. So this video is supposed to be fun, it's supposed to be lighthearted, but it's also supposed to be helpful. So I am filming this intro on a different day than I actually did the tutorial. So if you haven't ever really like thought about it, I usually film my makeup tutorials kind of in reverse order. So I will do the makeup first, and then once my makeup's done, I'll film my intro. Okay. So I did this filming of this yesterday, but I did half my face like correctly and half my face horribly wrong. And there was no way I was filming an intro with a crazy half and half face. So I am filming this a different day. So if you're wondering why like my hair looks different, my clothes look different, I'm filming this on a completely different day. Today's video is supposed to be, again, a lot of fun, and hopefully you will learn something. So are you ready to get started? Let's go. The first makeup mistake to avoid is not taking care of your skin. It actually has nothing to do with makeup. You know, on this channel, I love talking about skincare. In fact, I have an entire playlist dedicated just to that. So I'll link that up here. But taking care of your skin is the most important step to having your makeup look amazing. So we're gonna keep talking, and I'm actually going to start applying my skincare. I just washed my face, but one of the things that you want to do is you want to make sure that you are washing your face every single night before you go to bed. And if you wear makeup, it's a great idea to do that double cleanse. And so that is using a cleanser to take your makeup off. Then you would use a cleanser that is specific to your skin type or your skin concern. So for instance, you know, I love to use my Mary Kay Naturally Cleanser to remove my makeup. And then I come in with my Timewise Repair Volume Firm Foaming Cleanser. So I get those great anti-aging benefits. So if you've noticed, I'm only applying skincare to half of my face. And that is my, again, first makeup mistake to avoid. You wanna make sure that we are applying skincare underneath of our makeup. So yes, we wanna use skincare at night. Super, super important. Cleansing our face, using products at night that are specifically for night, because that's gonna help to repair and rebuild, restore the skin while we sleep. But then in the morning, we wanna go ahead and do a quick wash, whether that's with a gentle cleanser or just even a warm washcloth. And then we want to apply a moisturizer that is specific for our skin type. So you see, I'm just doing half my face, and that is because this half of my face, for the purposes of this video, I'm going to do everything correctly, or everything that I would typically do. And then this side, I'm going to do the makeup mistakes to avoid. So first step, do your skincare. Apply a moisturizer, a lightweight moisturizer, but make sure that it's not too heavy. Make sure it's not too greasy. Same with the eye cream. You want to apply, you saw I just put a little bit, I patted it in. And if you noticed, I just put my eye cream underneath of my eye. I did not put it on my lid. Now, the reason for that is my skin does tend to be more on the oily side, and my eyelids as well. I do not want oil or, you know, anything heavy on my eyelids. It's that's going to break up the makeup or cause it to not last as long. So really it would depend on your skin type. If you have super, super dry skin, you may need a little bit of moisture all around your eyes, even on your lid during the day. But that's something you wanna just, you know, let your skin tell you what it needs and play around with it. You know, maybe one day try the eye cream under your makeup and then try it without one day and see if your eye makeup lasts longer, if it, you know, creases or fades or anything like that during the day. Another thing you want to do is when you do apply your moisturizer, again, keep it light, and you want to give it time for it to absorb into your skin. Because if you apply your moisturizer and immediately go in with your foundation, you haven't allowed the moisturizer to penetrate into the skin, and all of that product that's sitting on top of the skin is going to start to break down the makeup. It's going to break it down faster. So I also did a video, if you have really, really oily skin and you have a hard time with, you know, knowing what to do with a moisturizer, because you feel like you put moisturizer on and it just completely breaks your makeup down. And so, you know, you want to skip it. Or if you, you know, don't wear it at all, it's like you need that moisture. So I did a oily skin hack video, and I will link that up here as well. So the oily skin hack, you can apply your moisturizer, give it a few minutes to absorb in, and you can actually take the Mary Kay Beauty blotters and you can blot off some of that extra moisture. Because if you wait about 10 minutes, your skin is going to absorb what it needs at that time. So give it a little bit of time, let it absorb, blot off the extra, and then go on with the rest of your makeup. So that's a great hack for oily skin. All right, so this has absorbed in just for a few minutes, so I'm actually gonna give it a little bit more time to start the application on this side of my face. So the next makeup mistake that we're gonna talk about is using the wrong shade of foundation. How many times have you seen a woman and she has this line right here and her face is not the same color as her neck, her décolleté area? So a lot of times women are just so confused about what their skin undertone is, what color looks best on them. If you're going into a store or you're ordering online, it's so hard to determine what the right color is for you. Down in the description box, I'm going to link a foundation finder quiz that is on my personal website, and it is the best tool to help you determine which formula and shade is right for you in our Mary Kay foundation line. So it doesn't seem like it would be accurate because it's only a couple of questions, but I'm telling you, all of my customers that have taken it, myself included, it has been amazing at figuring out the right shade of foundation. So go ahead and finish watching the video, but then click on that link and figure out what your perfect match is. So I am going to use the wrong shade of foundation on this face and one that matches my skin tone on this side. So let me get started. And the reason that I want to show you this, number one, is I want to show you what it looks like when you wear the wrong shade of foundation, but also what it looks like when you don't put your skincare on underneath. So One of the things that I have seen over my years of doing Mary Kay is so many women want to look tan. They tell me, oh, my skin is so light and I just want to look like, you know, darker than that. So they try to fix that problem by choosing a foundation that is too dark for their skin tone. So they pick a foundation that is two or three shades darker than their skin tone. And again, they get that line. And that is really the wrong way to go about it. So if you want to have your skin look more tan, then what you want to do is still use a foundation that is your skin tone and your skin's shade, but then use bronzer to warm up your skin rather than just going darker on your foundation. And I'm using the Mary Kay blending brush to apply this shade. Another mistake is applying too much product. The Mary Kay product, a little bit goes a long way, so you don't need a really, really thick, heavy coverage. Now, with all of the lights that I use, well, all of the lights, I have two lights. I have my vanity lights and then I have a ring light. So I'm not sure if this is gonna show up that great on camera, but I might even turn the lights off for a minute in a little bit so you can see the difference. Now I'm going to do the correct application on this side, and I'm actually going to do something I forgot to do on the other side, but I don't think it really matters because the other side is not the right color anyway. But I want to come in with my color corrector first. So that goes on underneath of my eye, and I'm going to use the Mary Kay cream color brush just to blend that in a little bit. So this is going to help correct the dark circles under my eyes. And I also kind of get it right there in that inner corner. So I apply this first to do that color correction, and then I will come in with the foundation. All right, so I'm going to use a lighter foundation that is more my skin tone. It is February here when I'm filming this video, and I have not been out in the sun a lot, and my skin is more pale this time of year. So instead of wearing that darker shade of foundation, I'm going to wear one that matches my skin tone. And then if I want to warm up my skin, again, like I said earlier, I can use a little bit of bronzer to do that. On this side, I'm using the Mary Kay liquid foundation brush. I love this brush. I would say it is my favorite. You can also use that blending brush that you saw me use a minute ago, or you could use the blending sponge, and you know, any of those options is great. I say pick your favorite and go with it. And I love having all of them because my mood changes and I like to use different things, but this is typically my go-to is the liquid foundation brush. So I start with a light layer, and then if you need a little bit more, oh wow, you can really see how this is not the right shade, right? So if you need a little bit more, you can just pick up a little bit more and just kind of come in the areas where you need it rather than a really thick, heavy layer all over your face. It's so weird looking at the mirror and the camera right now. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is crazy. All right, the next makeup mistake we're gonna talk about is your eyebrows. So you guys know I'm all about my eyebrows. I love using my Mary Kay brow products, and I really work to perfect my brow routine. And I do have a video, and I will link that up here. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to do my brow correctly on this side and not correctly on this side. So if you've watched that brow video, you know I've talked about where to start your brow, where the arch is, and where to stop it. So I'm not gonna go into a lot of detail, but I will do it correctly here. And then I'll show you what I'm gonna do on this side to make it a makeup mistake. So I'm using my Mary Kay Precision Brow Liner in dark brunette. And I'm also going to use a little bit of the brunette tinted brow gel for a little bit of extra volume. Now on this side, I'm going to show you what happens when you don't know where to start and stop your brow. And I have actually seen this in a bunch of pictures and videos on social media lately, and I'm not really sure if maybe I'm missing out on a trend that is going around, but I'm literally seeing women whose eyebrows are like super close together in the front, and so they're bringing this in super close to the other one. And again, I don't know, maybe it's a trend, but I feel like I've noticed it a ton lately. So let me show you again. If we extend that brow a really long, you know, way inside and outside, I'm going to show you what that looks like. So let me do this eye. Okay, let's move on. So the next makeup mistake I am going to talk about is your eyeshadow. Not blending your eyeshadow is a huge mistake. Let's see what happens when we apply our makeup and don't blend versus when we blend. I will link the colors below. So the next makeup mistake that I see is wearing eyeliner only on the bottom. So I've noticed in the analytics for my videos that most of my viewers, the majority of them, are 35 plus. So my goal with my makeup tutorials is to help you with just your everyday makeup and things that are going to help you as you start to age. So we know that we can't apply our makeup in our 40s and 50s like we used to when we were in our teens and 20s. There are certain techniques techniques that we need to master to be able to make our face look more uplifted, and we want to make it look, you know, more youthful. So when we only wear eyeliner on the bottom, I want to show you what happens and how it drags the eye down. So let me do the correct side and again the makeup mistake. So I have the Mary Kay eyeliner in black. This is the eyeliner pencil. Next, I'm just gonna apply a little bit of mascara. This is the lash level lengthening. The next makeup mistake I'm gonna talk about is bronzer and contour and some of those mistakes that we can make. So one of the things that you wanna make sure to do is when you are using a contour that you actually use a powder that is labeled a contour powder, not a bronzer. Contour and bronzer are two different things. And if you look on my Tip Tuesday playlist, I believe I did a video about the difference between bronzer and contour. So you can check that out. But I'm gonna apply some contour on this side of my face. I'm gonna show you where that goes and how to apply it. And then I'm going to do the mistake on this side, and I'm actually going to use a bronzer as a contour. And I'm gonna show you what happens when you do that and if it's not applied and blended correctly. So I have my contour in latte. So I'm gonna take a little bit of that on the cheek color brush right there. And I don't know if I've showed this before. There's like a little divot right there for your finger. And if you apply a pressure, it makes the brush a little bit smaller and you can kind of really angle that in exactly where you need it. So right there under my cheekbone. So you want to make sure though that you blend that out. So you can use the same brush, or you could even come in with a different brush and you could just blend that out. Just remember to blend upward and not down here. So we don't want to move the product really around the face. We just want to soften those edges. Just creating that little bit of depth right there under the cheekbone. Now, when I use a bronzer is not designed to be used as a contour. So it is not a matte shade, it is a shimmer shade. So I'm gonna apply some of this underneath. And I am using one that's actually a little bit too dark for my skin tone. Because again, I want to show the mistakes. So I'm going to put a little bit down here as well. And I'm going to blend it just a little bit, but not very much, because I want to show you what happens when we don't blend it. Next up, let's talk about cheek color and makeup mistakes when it comes to that. One of the things that we want to make sure is that we have our cheek color placement just right, especially as we age, because if we apply it in the wrong place, it can make us look older. It can make our face look, you know, not as uplifted, not as youthful. So I am going to start with the correct application on this side, and I'm going to use a just really pretty pink shade. So I'm going to take my cheek color brush, and I just have that on there. So again, I'll link all these colors below because I don't even know what I'm using right now. I'm just grabbing stuff. So do you see how my cheekbone is right here, and I'm really just applying this color on the cheekbone and coming up, just that lifted effect. So I'm not coming too close to my nose. I actually don't want to come in any closer than my pupil. I don't want it, the product down here, and I don't want it right here on the apple of my cheek. And you might wonder why. So when we smile and we get the apple of our cheek, how many of you were taught in your teens and 20s that's where you apply blush, right? Smile, get the apple of your cheek. Well, when you're young, your face doesn't move as much as, I guess, when you're younger, as far as, you know, everything. As we get a little bit older, it starts to like droop down just a little bit. So what happens when I smile and then when I'm not smiling? So my cheekbone is not, you know, my cheek, the apple of my cheek is not in the same place, right? So if you apply your cheek color to the apples of your cheeks and then you're not smiling, you're gonna get a totally different look with your blush. So that's what I'm gonna do on this side. So I'm gonna use that same color and I'm gonna smile and apply it right there to the apple of my cheek. Need a little bit more. This foundation's too dark, so. So see what happens, and you know, I'm not getting that uplifted effect on this side like I am on this side. Next up, let's talk about highlighter. So I'm gonna do just a touch of highlighter, and you wanna make sure that when you apply it just above the cheekbone. I love to use the long end of this brush. I'm gonna take a little bit of highlighter, just a tiny bit, and just come right at the top of my cheekbone, being careful not to get too close to these crow's feet that I have right here, because I don't want to accentuate or highlight those. So I've just got a little bit, and so I'm going to show you, if I just put too much and put it right here, that's what can happen. It can really accentuate those crow's feet. And we don't want to apply the highlighter just everywhere all over our face. So I'm just going to show you if I apply it, you know, down too low as well. So we want to keep the highlighter really strategically placed just at the top of that cheekbone. The next makeup mistake is about our lips. So one of the things that I've seen is not matching your lip liner to your lips or your lipstick. So if you were a, you know, child of the 80s and 90s growing up, you may have remembered a trend where it was a very, very dark brown liner with almost a nude lip. Well, that was a trend. That is not a thing right now that I'm aware of. So I know some of that 90s makeup is coming back, but you know, again, most of the women that are watching my channel are not looking for trendy makeup. And so that's why you don't see me do a lot of trends on here. I've thought about doing a trend video for this year and maybe how to make some of that wearable. If you'd like to see that, let me know. I haven't decided quite if I want to do that yet or not, but you know, we on this channel are talking about everyday makeup for every woman, something that you can wear to the office, you can wear, you know, when you're out running errands, you can wear it to church, things like that. So I want to show you everyday, you know, makeup that you can do. So if we do lipstick, it's a great idea as we age to wear liner, but you want to match your liner to either your natural lip color, or you want to match it really closely to your lipstick. It doesn't have to be the exact same shade, but it should definitely be the same color family, and it should be within a couple of shades. So let me show you. I have the rose lip liner here. So let me line my lips real quick. Now let me show you what's gonna happen if I wear a lipstick that matches. So I have Mauve Moments, and it matches the rose almost perfectly. So let me put that on. Now let me show you if I wear this is just a nude lipstick. This is the Naturally Buff. So if I wore this with this rose lip liner, I'll show you what it would look like. Now you could argue that having a darker lip liner or a lighter lipstick is an ombre effect. Certainly do an ombre lip, but that is going to be very intentional, and you still want to use shades within the same color family and just gradually work from darker to lighter, and darker on the outside to lighter on the inside. But you can see if my lipstick were to wear off, I would have this, you know, rose lip liner, and it would just look kind of crazy on there. And the last makeup mistake that we're going to talk about today is the translucent loose powder. So you guys know that I love my translucent loose powder, especially with having that oilier skin. It's something really important. But if you cake it on and you just put so much on your face, you could actually accentuate your lines and wrinkles. So we want to do a really light dusting of that translucent powder. So let me get this out. And I forgot to close the cap, so I have like so much in here. I need to, it's gonna make a mess, but that's okay. So I'm gonna take some on here. I'm gonna really shake off a lot of that excess. Still kind of a lot, but all right. So I'm gonna start to lightly dust this all over that T-zone area for me. I'm gonna get just a tiny bit more. And I'm gonna come in right here. All right, and then I'm gonna take the other side and I'm gonna apply like a lot of it so you can see what happens. So if you apply, there's gonna be a lot on the camera probably floating around, so I apologize. But I don't know how many of you see women bake their makeup. This is called baking. And I know people don't bake necessarily their whole face, but I just wanna kind of show the point. All right, so let me let that sit for a moment. I have powder all over me. Not only is it like not great, but it gets everywhere. I have powder everywhere, all over this vanity right now, and all over my shirt. All right, so normally when you bake, you're gonna leave it set there for a while, but I wanna finish up here. So I'm gonna brush off. So that was all the makeup mistakes that I wanted to go over in this video. I hope that you can see how making these mistakes doesn't give you the best look. And I know that a lot of times someone's gonna do one mistake. They're not gonna do every single one of these mistakes all at one time. And if these are some of the techniques that you follow, please know that this video is not meant to be judgment. It's not meant to, you know, be negative in any way. It is just to hopefully help you to maybe change and tweak one or two little things to help your makeup look more youthful, make it look more radiant, and maybe last longer, or you know, something like that. Okay, so I'm gonna get closer and I'm gonna show you how that baking with the powder, how my wrinkles are more accentuated on this side. So let me get closer. So I don't know if you can tell on this side, but I don't feel like I have a lot of wrinkles showing, but on this side, can you see that? Can you see those wrinkles? So I'll smile. Do you see the difference with the powder baking? So that's one thing that just really avoid applying like a super heavy layer of powder on your face because it can be really aging. I know it is very hard to, you know, when we have like the combination of oily skin, it's so hard because we want a lot of powder because we want to like soak up that oil. But really go back to what I said earlier about the skincare. Get your skincare right and you won't have to worry about as much powder. So I don't know if you can see with me coming in closer too with the skin tone. This looks more skin-like and this just looks like I have makeup on. So, and then the eyes, you guys, I don't ever get this close to the camera because I don't like y'all seeing all my wrinkles, but that's okay. I want to really show you the difference. And even with the brows, so obviously I have a lot about brow product. I have the pencil and the tinted brow gel on this side, but look how more natural it looks than this side, where I'm like really extending that brow, and so it's obvious that I'm drawing it on. So this one is more, you know, subtle. I mean, you can tell that I'm probably using some brow products. And then something else, so the liner down here, do you see how like everything on this side of my face just looks more droopy, right? Okay, so that was it for today. And I know this video was really long, so thank you for hanging in there. And I hope you learned a lot. Comment below and let me know if you make any of these makeup mistakes, because look, I've made them. Don't worry about it. I've made all these mistakes too. And that's how I can teach you, because I've made them. And so now I know what not to do, right? So if you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share it with a friend. And if you're not subscribed to the channel yet, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and hit that red button right this minute. All right, friends, I will see you in the next video. Bye now. If you liked today's video, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit that red subscribe button and check out these other videos I have for you here. All right, I'll see you next time, friends.